For some reason, it seems like this is what everyone wants. CarPlay on Tesla, the best of both worlds, the best of the iPhone software and the best of Tesla's hardware, all working together and living in harmony. But I don't know, maybe I'm just crazy, but I don't see the appeal. As someone who owned a car with Apple CarPlay and used it and loved it for many years, owning a Tesla has given me a very different perspective on a car's infotainment system and just how, in a way, inferior CarPlay was to what Tesla's superior software is bringing to the table. But I understand that there are people who like CarPlay, and I actually understand kind of the pros to why you want to bring CarPlay to the Tesla. So I'm going to explain what those are and kind of how to make the best of both worlds come together and how to kind of put CarPlay on your Tesla. So let me just back up a second. The whole idea of CarPlay and the concept of CarPlay is something I can really get behind, and as someone, like I said, who used CarPlay for years, I really loved it. And if you think about the idea and the premise of CarPlay, it makes a whole lot of sense. You have car manufacturers who are notoriously slow and just bad at making car entertainment and infotainment systems. The software is slow, it's buggy, it's underpowered, it just never worked right, and people would usually just rely on their phones to stream Bluetooth audio to the car because all they really wanted to do for many years was just play their music and play it wirelessly in the car. And over the years, as it was made pretty clear that car manufacturers were just not jumping on the tech bandwagon, Apple kind of helped them out in a sense by releasing CarPlay. This was a car's infotainment system that ran on the iPhone that the person already had. As long as the basically onboard computer could support it, you could plug in your phone, CarPlay would go on the screen, touchscreen would work, all the controls, and everything was pretty easy. This was great because you could get all the software updates through Apple and iOS, and you would get all the different software updates and interface changes to CarPlay and third-party app support without having to wait for the auto manufacturer to implement it on their end. Obviously, they had to make that initial support for CarPlay to actually work on the car, but once that worked, for the most part, it was up to Apple and third-party developers to continue to bring updates and make it more useful over time. And at first, CarPlay wasn't so great. It was locked to Apple Maps. There was really no third-party app support, and it was basically like a glorified phone on your screen. It was way better than a lot of the infotainment systems from its time, but it wasn't exactly perfect. Then over the years, it got better, especially with the support of third-party maps. And when you could use Waze on CarPlay, I remember using Waze on my Honda Civic, that was the best thing and made it basically a game changer. I no longer saw the need to judge a car by its infotainment system. As long as it supported CarPlay, it was a win in my book and it was going to be awesome. And as CarPlay got better and more third-party apps came to it, I used it a lot more. I was able to play Spotify songs back and have that control and have it all built into my steering wheels. Built-in physical buttons. I could take calls. I could send texts with Siri. Obviously, I had third-party map support, podcast support. It was great. It was, again, way better than what the car manufacturer was going to build into the software. And in many cases, auto manufacturers are just basically building a very simple shell that was not supposed to be fancy because you could plug in Android Auto or CarPlay into your car, run that software, and it was going to be way better. And it made a whole lot of sense and worked really well and still continues to work for a lot of people. But Tesla's vehicles, the S, the X, the Y, the 3, the S, they are very different cars in the best way possible. And as many pros as you can think of for owning a Tesla are out there, one of the biggest is the tech built into the car. Tesla is a very technology forward-thinking company. They implement technology and they do it fast. And the software on Teslas is so different than auto manufacturers in the typical sense. It is the antithesis of an infotainment system in the best possible way. The Tesla software built into the car is not bad. It is great. It is feature packed and it just keeps getting better with software update after software update. And because Tesla doesn't have a super huge fleet of different vehicles they're producing, they're able to make their software custom tailored for their cars. Changing the air is as simple as dragging around a visual cue. You're able to have total voice commands that work throughout the car. You have the ability to change the mirrors, the steering wheel. Everything is just like a lot better integrated. It's seamlessly integrated with the hardware hardware and the software. Just like Apple, who makes the iPhone, is basically making both the hardware and the software and doing that in a way that's super seamless and intuitive, Tesla is doing the same thing. They're a tech company, they're a forward-facing tech company, they're working hard to make technology kind of the bread and butter of their cars, and in my opinion, they're doing a great job, and I love the way the software and the hardware work together so seamlessly. One of the things right off the bat that the car is missing is any kind of real virtual assistant. And obviously, Tesla software is getting better and the voice commands are getting better, but you can't ask the questions like you'd ask Siri or Google Assistant. It can't pull up the weather or news information. It is a lot more limited in that sense, and it's nice to be able to use the power of Google Assistant and Siri and other virtual assistants, even Amazon Alexa with their own Alexa in the car, Alexa Echo Auto kind of thing. Having access to those third-party virtual assistants is really nice and something you cannot do, at least natively, from the Tesla without going through some kind of workaround or using Bluetooth or something like that. Another difference is cell data. So when you're using CarPlay or Android Auto, because everything is running off of your phone, the data is also going, of course, through your phone. It's going through the cell plan you already pay for. With Tesla, things are different. On one hand, it's really nice that the car has its own cell connection, and usually, in many cases, gets better reception than my phone does, and allows me to stream YouTube videos and stream music and get satellite maps and all that great stuff. But on the other hand, you're paying for that. Sometimes you can obviously not pay for that if you have a certain spec of car, at least you get it for a while. But as a Standard Range Plus owner, I've detailed this in a video, link to up here and all that stuff, I'm paying 10 bucks a month to have access to streaming media and all that stuff. Obviously, you don't have to pay that $10, but if you don't have Tesla's premium connectivity package, you're really missing out on a lot of the great features the car has to offer. So I'm paying the $10 a month. It would be nice if I could basically use my phone's data as the car's, you know, SIM in a sort, to be able to get all the data that my car would need from the phone, which you can technically do through a personal hotspot, though it doesn't really work the same way. You guys know what I'm saying. If you could basically use the cell data you're already paying for to use that for your car and not have to pay anything additional. Something nice with CarPlay and Android Auto that is not the same with Tesla. Another thing really holding Tesla back, which supposedly they're working on, is any kind of real third-party app store or real third-party app support. Obviously, Spotify being included in the car is a huge deal, and everybody is very thankful for that. But if you're like an Audible subscriber and you want to be able to play back your audiobooks in your car, there is no native way to do that on the screen. You can control it with your phone, but that's certainly not the same as like Spotify, which is built into the car. Also, podcast support. I'm not a huge fan of the built-in podcast player on the car. I'd love to use something like Overcast or Google Podcasts or Apple Podcasts. There is no way to do that because there is no third-party podcast app support. And the same goes for music, you know, no Pandora support, no Apple Music support. You guys kind of get the idea. You know, CarPlay and Android Auto are basically able to add these features a lot faster. They're able to rely on third-party developers to bring these apps in, and they're able to use them, and they work really well in their respective kind of car infotainment systems. Obviously, there's a reason Tesla doesn't do it, but I think that if they were to implement some kind of third-party app store, it would be a big deal and a big draw and a big thumbs up for many people, developers and consumers, to use more apps built into their car. I love the pace that Tesla's working to add new features. I love that they are always listening. Elon is definitely always listening, and they're adding more and more features, and they're working very well, but it would be nice to have some kind of third-party app developer support or third-party app support to allow developers to really get in there and make some really cool stuff. And then besides just apps, third-party maps is a big one. Everybody wants Waze on the Tesla, which I get that, but on another hand, you know, Tesla is based off of Google Maps. It uses Google Maps and Google Maps, you know, traffic data to do all the visualizations and all of the route planning and all the navigation. So on one hand, I have no issues with the mapping system built into the Tesla, but Waze support would be nice. Everybody loves, you know, the accident reports, the police detection, all that stuff, and kind of the smart mapping it's able to do. Not a big deal for me, but I do understand the want and the desire for many people to be able to switch out that mapping system with something else. So as of right now, there is no magical way to hook up your car and be able to get CarPlay on your Tesla or Android Auto on your Tesla. Obviously, for the lack of third-party app support, you can just use your phone over Bluetooth to basically do whatever you want, but it's certainly not the same. So is there a way to kind of hack together something to kind of make CarPlay work on the Tesla? Well, there kinda is, but let me warn you, it's not perfect. It's definitely buggy, but try it for yourself because it does, in theory, actually kind of work. So if you don't like the way that the Spotify built-in app is working, you're actually able to use the Spotify website to have a little bit of a better, more traditional interface for your Spotify controls. It basically is remote controlling the Spotify instance in your car, but you're able to load up the web browser, go to Spotify, and basically have the full featured Spotify experience from your browser. Unfortunately, there's not really any real Apple Music support or Pandora support, but there is better Spotify navigation and a better Spotify interface if you're willing to do a little extra work that is an option for you. There also is a web-based Waze, which I know kind of sounds crazy, but it does actually kind of work. I'm gonna link it down in the description below, but you can kind of see it here working. It technically, it does work and it does kind of look like Waze, but it's definitely not as simple and as seamless as the built-in map. You can run this in a browser. You do have to, you know, go to the browser and run the page and kind of keep it up and running, which is a little distracting and especially not super conducive when you're trying to use the other map simultaneously for navigation and stuff like that. But you can actually use this. It does actually work. So if you really, really, really want Waze on your Tesla, this is a kind of a way to make a workaround work and kind of make it happen, at least for the time being. And same for podcasts. You can use web-based podcast players like the Pocket Cast website to be able to play back audio in your car. Though the big caveat here is that while you're driving, Tesla disables audio in the browser. So obviously they don't want people watching movies over Plex, but that also means you can't play back audio and play back things like podcasts in a third-party player. Works while you're parked, so consider that a kind of a win and you can control from your car, but you can't actually do it while you're driving, unfortunately, at least not right now. Messaging is something that was actually missing for a while, and I gotta give Tesla credit for it. They have actually updated this and built it into the software, and it continues to get better, though it is certainly not perfect. Right now, it has a lot of shortcomings. It won't kind of bring down the volume of what you're listening to. Like if you're listening to a song and a text comes through, Android Auto and Apple CarPlay will kind of bring down the audio and let you hear the text. Tesla does not do that. It doesn't handle group threads very well. Some stuff it will not decipher. It doesn't handle a lot of incoming messages very well. And what drives me nuts is it doesn't respect Do Not Disturb on different threads that you set on your device onto the car. So there's a little bit of tinkering there to do and some stuff to get worked out, but it is kind of nice to see messaging come to the car because that was a big thing that Android Auto and CarPlay had that the Tesla just did not have for many, many years. So what's the answer to this? Is CarPlay on the Tesla going to be something that's going to happen? Is Tesla going to open up their software to Apple and Google and other manufacturers to make this whole cohesive car experience become a reality? I don't think so, but I think that's for the best. CarPlay and Android Auto are certainly great systems, and I have a lot of love for them and respect for them, and I've used them, and they are great, but I still think that Tesla in the long run is going to be better. Right now, we are going through some pain points with mapping, with third-party app support, with music support, and certainly with text message support, but it is getting better. Tesla is continuing to push frequent software updates and iterating over time to add these features in and make it better. And just in the past year, version 10 especially has brought so many software features to this car that it was missing, and the Tesla can still do things that other cars just cannot do. You can't watch YouTube videos, at least natively, from CarPlay or Android Auto on your car. The streaming services are still just really well done, and the integration between software and the car's hardware is still much better than Apple and Google because Tesla is kind of taking the Apple model. They can do both and have ultimate control. So yeah, we're going through some pain points right now. There are lots of features I would love to see, and in a lot of ways, CarPlay and Android Auto are still superior. But I will say this, I believe in Tesla. They have the best engineers working there. They have brilliant minds doing their software and hardware, and I believe that these updates will come over time and bring new features. So we just gotta wait a little bit longer to get these things in the car, but I think eventually they will come. And I do, again, think that if Tesla does open at least a little bit of the system up to third-party developers, it's going to be a really big deal and a really big win for both developers and consumers. So what do you guys think? Do you want to see CarPlay? So what do you guys think? Do you want to see CarPlay or Android Auto on your Tesla? What is the biggest feature that's missing from the car's infotainment system that you would love to see that is not on there right now? Leave a comment down below and let me know. And I hope you guys just enjoyed this video, a little discussion, a little talk about different infotainment systems and what Tesla's doing right and what is Tesla doing wrong. These are my thoughts, but I'd also love to know yours, so leave them in the comments down below. As always, thank you guys so much for everything. I'm Robert Rosenfeld, and I'll see you in the next one.